Well, friends, welcome to our today's session. We'll be discussing the topic depreciation and tax planning concepts. Very quickly, I am going to share the file with you. You might have already heard, you might be knowing what is depreciation, right? When any business use some asset for the purpose of its own operation, the value of the assets keep on decreasing over a period of time because of use, because of a fraction of time, or because of simply, you can say this is a kind of loss in the value of the asset, right? And that loss is charged to the profit over the life of the asset. So that is the normal concept. Suppose you are using a asset and the life of the asset is 10 years. So every year, the value, certain part of the value is charged to the profit and loss statement of the entity so that the real profit can be arrived at. So that is the purpose. You have heard about depreciation. You know what is depreciation or not? Do you know what is depreciation?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, suppose let us say value of the asset is 1 lakh rupees and life of the asset is 10 years. So we'll plan it in such a way that in the 10 years, the entire value of the asset is charged to the business, charged to the profit and loss statement. Okay, so there are various methods of depreciation. One you might have heard, straight line method. That means every year at a fixed amount will be charged. And any other method have you heard of? I told one is straight line method. Any other method have you heard of? Have you heard of written down value method, WDV?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so that is one more method. WDV method, let us say first year, you charge 10% on a value of 1 lakh rupees. So first year, depreciation is 10,000 rupees. Now WDV becomes 90,000 rupees. That is 1 lakh minus 10,000. Next year, you'll be charging depreciation again 10% on 90,000. So next year, depreciation will be 9,000 rupees like this. That is called WDV method of depreciation. In income tax law, there are fixed methods of charging depreciation. Okay, generally it is WDV, except certain exceptions where straight line method is allowed. But normally WDV method is used. And that too, rates are also fixed. Not that on the basis of life you can decide what is the rate at which you'll be charging depreciation. It's not like that. Rates are also fixed. And we have to report to certain rules. Those rules will be helping us to understand what is depreciation. Depreciation rates also will be learning. Now, I'm going to share the screen with you. Let us learn all these concepts one by one. And at the outset, let us understand that the concept of depreciation is provided under section 32 and some related sections are there also. 32, 33, 34, something related to depreciation. But the prime section is 32. Section 32 deals with depreciation. And as you can see in the slide, it is written, the charge of depreciation is mandatory. That means compulsorily, this has to be given. Meaning, even if the assessee has not claimed depreciation in its income tax return, assessing officer shall still allow. Okay, it's not a choice that you can claim depreciation. It's mandatory. Okay, so section 32 allows deduction in respect of depreciation resulting from the diminution or accession in the value of the certain capital assets. If certain capital assets, what are those assets? I'll be showing you that list. If these are the capital assets whose value has been diminished or if assets are getting exhausted over a period of time, then certain deduction is allowed under section 32. Okay. And the explanation 5 to that particular section provides that it is a compulsory deduction. Whether or not assessee has claimed, that doesn't matter. But deduction shall be allowed in order to compute the total income. Okay, is it clear? It's a mandatory deduction. There are certain conditions which needs to be satisfied. And we need to go through this rule 5 of the Income Tax Rule 1962 to understand the concept of depreciation. Okay, I'll be taking you to the Income Tax Department website right now to explain it. But before that, one more concept, let us understand that the assets in respect of which depreciation can be claimed cost belong to following categories. That means only you can charge depreciation only for those category of assets. Can you read it here? What are these assets? You see, the two bullet points are there. So let us read one of them. Meaning only for these assets you can claim depreciation. Can you read it out? First bullet point.
Buildings,
then
machinery, plant or furniture being tangible assets.
So if the assets are tangible assets, the depreciation can be allowed only for buildings, machinery, plant and furniture. Okay, right. And in case they're intangible, depreciations are allowed only for these assets. Can you read it out? Second bullet point.
Know-how, patents, copyrights, trademarks, licenses, franchises, or any other business or commercial rights of similar nature.
So if there's intangible assets, and that too they must have acquired before, acquired on or after 1st April 1998. So prior to that, depreciation was not allowed on intangible assets. But from 1st April 1998 onwards, depreciation is allowed on intangible asset. But intangible asset must belong to know-how, patent, copyright, trademark, license, franchise, or any business right or a commercial. So if your asset belong to this category, then only depreciation can be charged. Okay. Did you understand this concept? So first,
yes,
concept,
sir.
I told you it is a mandatory charge. It has to be charged. Okay, in order to compute the taxable income, we have to charge depreciation. Second concept what we learned, depreciation can be charged only the asset belong to certain categories. Right? So now I'm taking you to the Income Tax Department website. Let us learn some useful things which will be helping us to do tax planning as regards to depreciation. Let me share the screen with you right now. You have to please interact. Tell me what you are seeing on the screen. What are you seeing? Which page I am showing you?
Google.
Okay, Google search engine page you are seeing. Now you see what I am typing now. Can you read it here? What I have typed here. Can you tell me?
IncomeTaxIndia.gov.in.
Yes, this is the homepage address of Income Tax Department. So let us go to Income Tax Department to understand the concept of depreciation first of all. Now you can see this is the concept of depreciation. As I told you, first of all, what are the things related to depreciation? If you want to learn the sections, I can take you to the sections. You can go to the ARC. I told you section 32 and some related sections. Let me take you to Income Tax Act first of all to explain you. Let me take you to section 32 first of all. Now you see section 32, you can understand this is about depreciation. 32 about investment allowances, etc. But 32 is about depreciation. Can you see it?
Yes, sir.
If I enter there, click enter, you can understand depreciation can be charged on which assets. You can read the provisions directly. This is the provision related to depreciation. This is one thing you should know. Then one more thing, as I told you right now, you also need to learn Rule 5 of Income Tax Act to understand Income Tax Rule 1962, understand depreciation. For that thing, again, I'm taking it to the home page. Okay, home page, you see, I'm taking ARCS. Here is a link for rules. Are you seeing it? Rules?
Yeah.
Okay. Rules. Now you see income tax rules. Which rule I told you?
Rule 5.
Rule 5. You see, this is one page. It is not available up to rule T. 2C is available. You can search it or directly you can rule number, you can type it here. You can type it here, rule 5. Okay, you can search, you can find rule 5. Now you see rule 5. Can you read it? What is written here?
Depreciation.
Depreciation. You can read, I told you section 32 also you can read. You can also read rule 5 of the Income Tax Act, rule 1962, to understand the concept of depreciation. Okay, I will be explaining you most of these concepts. Understood? Rule 1, rule 2. No, sir, rule 5 and section 32. Two things are important. Then one more thing let me tell you, what will be helpful to you, is about know the rates of depreciation. Is it not? As I told you earlier, the depreciation under income tax law will be charged at a fixed rate. It doesn't depend upon the life of the assets. Okay. What the law provides, according to that, depreciation has to be charged. Now, you might be wondering, what are these rates? Yes or no? Should I show you the rates? The rate of depreciation?
Yes, sir.
Now, where to find it? Let me take you to this place. Earlier, I might have taken you to this place. Can you see here the link? Can you see the link here? What is written?
Tax charts and tables.
Tax charts and tables. So here you can find out the depreciation rate. Let me click it here. Now you see, these are various tables and charts will be available here. Just read it, find out if depreciation rates are there. Just tell me, are you seeing it, depreciation rate anywhere? Are you able to see it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I must go there. Okay, so let me click here. I can find the rates of depreciation. Now you see, this is the rate of depreciation. Are you seeing this chart? Okay, now you see, in this column 1, what you are seeing? Block of assets, first tangible assets are there, after that intangible assets will be there. So this says the assets description. Then what is the depreciation allowance? You see, this is for assessment year 2003, 4 to 5, 6. This is for 2006, 7 to 17, 18. But 18, 19 onwards, this is the depreciation. So which column is relevant for us? Column 2, 3 or 4? Which is relevant for us?
4.
Column 4 is relevant. Suppose if you want to know depreciation on the building, which is used mainly for residential purpose, except hotel boarding houses, the rate of depreciation is 5%. Okay, if it is building other than for residential houses not covered under item 1, then it is 10%. You have to see the last column. Okay, so purely temporary structure. Earlier it was 100%, now it is 40%. Okay, so this is, you see, called as a tangible asset, you see building, then furniture. Okay, building, you see, this is called as a block. Block 1, block 2, block 3, block 4. Four blocks are there under building. And rates of depreciation are 5%, sorry, 5%, 10% and 40%. Okay, 5, 10, 40, 40. Are you seeing it? Tell me, what is the rate of depreciation for furniture?
10%.
10%. Okay. Not 15%. Earlier it was 15%, but now it is 10%. But how many blocks are there under furniture and fittings?
One.
Only one block. Because only one rate of depreciation is charged. Now you see plant and machinery. You can see the least of plant and machinery. Plant and machinery not covered on all these things. You see some places 15%, some places 30%, some places 40%, some places 45%. Okay. You see, can see the least of plant and machinery. It is a big block, in fact. So many items are there. Okay. Are you seeing it? You can download it. You can find it out. Long list of items. Okay, different rates of depreciation. Then you see, one more category is the SIPs. Rates of depreciation is 20%. You can see it. Next comes intangible assets. Tell me, what is the rate of depreciation for intangible assets?
25%.
Okay. Now, there are certain notes also in this, right? You have to go through this. Building includes roads, bridges, culverts, wells, tube wells. They are also building. So, accordingly, the rate applicable to that will be charged. Okay. One by one, we'll be learning all this thing. This concept will be learning. Okay. Okay. What is the meaning of commercial vehicle? All these notes are also important. Now you see, can you read it here? Depreciation rate for? Can you read it? What is written here?
Power generating unit.
Power generating units. There is a special rate for them. Okay, if they are generating power or generating and distributing power, we'll be learning that thing. Rate of depreciation are different, but these are straight line method. But they have got an option. They may go for this rate or they may go for the earlier rate or the block asset concept. So this is a different rates are there for power generating companies. Okay. So like this, this is the rate. I think we got some idea how depreciation will be charged. Now, what is the rate of depreciation? We got some idea. Yes or no? I told you, I showed you. Here under Act, what I showed you here, which section? Have you remembered under Income Tax Act 1961? Which section is relevant for you? Have you remembered?
32.
Then we went to Income Tax Rules 1962. Which rule was important?
5.
Rule 5. Then tax rates and table, tax charts and tables. There we saw various depreciation rates. Now, one more thing I will be showing you. That is how to calculate depreciation. Now, here is the, what is this link here?
Tax tools.
Let me tell you how to use it. Tax tools. Tax tools, as you already know, tax tools, if you go there, you can find out various calculators. Right? Earlier, we have used this calculator, tax calculator, etc. We had already used. But today we are going to use depreciation calculator. You see, depreciation calculator is not here. Let me go to the second page. First page, it is not there. Tell me if you are finding depreciation calculator. Tell me if you are seeing depreciation calculator here. Is it there? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Here you can find depreciation calculator is there. Okay. Now let me tell you how to calculate depreciation. Okay, now when I click there, I find out this is a depreciation calculator. What you can see, depreciation on?
Plant and machinery.
Plant and machinery. For plant and machinery, you see these are the depreciation rates. 15, 30, 40, 50, 60, 80, 90. For other assets, this is, you can, I can go here. Let me show you how to deal with plant and machinery. First, you see, let us for assessment year 21-22, we'll see about. Okay, let us say our three rates are there. Let me go to 21-22. I told you, assessment year 21-22. Or we'll go to that 22-23. Right, so you see three rates are there. If you're talking about planted measure, 15%, 30%, 40%. There is one more concept of additional depreciation. I'll be telling you subsequently in certain situation. Certain entities who are engaged in manufacturing of certain thing, they're eligible for some additional depreciation. So now we'll say they're not eligible for additional depreciation. For 22-23, let us go for 15%, or you can choose 30%, or maybe 40%. You already know what is the, you know what is the rate you can refer, you can find it out. Is it done? Now, let us say, for example, I'm choosing it 15%. So let us see how to calculate depreciation. First, what you will do, what is written here? Can you read it? Can you read it out? Where I'm showing the
written
value. At the first day of the previous year. Okay, my assessment year is 21, 22, 23. That means previous year is what? 21-22. Okay, this what is running on, that is 21-22 previous year. So you have to find out what is the WDV at the first day of previous year. That means on the first April 2021, what is the written down value? How can I know it? The last year I must have charged depreciation. What is the after charging depreciation? What was the balance as of 31st March 2021? The same is the opening balance of 1st April 2021. Let us say written down value of the first day of the previous year is 10 lakh. Okay, here there is a concept, friend, I will be telling you subsequently. If the first year, or you can say if the new asset is acquired, and in the first year it is put to use for less than 180 days. That means if it is used for less than 6 months, 180 days. Then 50% of the depreciation will be charged. That means suppose normal depreciation is 15%, 7.5% will be charged. Suppose normal depreciation is 30%, that means 50% of that. That means 50% of 30. That means how much will be charged? 50% of 30.
15%.
So normal depreciation is 40%. Then how much will be charged? 20%. Which situation? If the asset is used for less than 180 days. If it is used for 180 days and more, then 100% depreciation. Okay, understood. So that is why people always try to, in case this is one of the tax planning also, you learn it. People always try to buy asset on, let's say, before October. Businessmen always will prefer to buy capital asset before October. If it is acquired before October, that means definitely it will be used for more than 180 days so that they can claim the entire depreciation. Right? Okay. If they use, for some reason, they used it post-October on such a day that asset is put to use for less than 180 days during the previous year, the depreciation rate will be reduced. Okay, let us say addition for a period of 180 days or more. Suppose some asset I have added during the previous year. Let us say I have added asset worth 4 lakh rupees. I will keep that thing. Amount of additional depreciation, we are saying additional depreciation is not eligible. So that is inactive. Okay, out of this newly added asset, if something is sold, let us say 4 lakh I have added, but out of that 4 lakh, 1 lakh is sold. That data I will give it here. Addition for a period less than 180 days. If it is more than 180 days, then it will be netted off. 4 lakh rupees I added, 1 lakh rupees I sold. So on 3 lakh rupees, 50% of the eligible depreciation will be applied. Okay. Eligible depreciation will be applied. But if I have added for a period less than, which is used for less than 180 days, that means post October I have acquired something, then on this 50% of eligible depreciation will be charged. Let us say I am writing 3 lakh here. Okay. Okay. If out of these 3 lakhs, some of the assets are already sold, let us say I sold asset worth 2 lakh rupees. Another 1 lakh rupees. Now, if I enter here, I can find out what is my depreciation. Depreciation on full rate is charged this much. Depreciation of half rate is not charged. Okay. So, total depreciation under income tax act is how much? This much. And the written down value in the last year of previous year is this much. Okay. Understood? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this is how you can use the depreciation calculator, which will be helpful to you. So we have learned various things. One is Section 32, we have seen how to update ourselves on the income tax laws. Rule 5 also we have seen. Tax charts and tables, you have seen the depreciation rates and tax calculators also I showed you. Okay, these are the various things which are relevant for us to understand the concept of depreciation. Now, I'm going to share with you the slide once again. As I told you, you have already also seen the depreciation can be charged only for these assets, building, machinery, plant, furniture. If they're intangible assets, and among intangible assets, know-how, patent, copyright, trademark, license, franchise, and business or commercial rights. These are the things on which depreciation can be charged. Now, friends, there are certain conditions which needs to be fulfilled for depreciation allowance. So let us quickly cover these conditions. First condition is that depreciation cannot be claimed in any other capital asset. That means except those assets which I showed you, no other asset depreciation can be claimed. Second point you have to remember, depreciation is not allowed on land. Okay, land is not subject to any depreciation. But let us say a building is situated on the land, one can charge depreciation on the building, that is on the superstructure itself, but no depreciation can be charged on land. Okay, and you already know, you have seen in the note also, note to that depreciation chart, you have seen plant includes ships, books are also plants, vehicles, scientific apparatus, surgical equipments, all of them shall be regarded as plant. But it doesn't include tea, bushes, livestock. Okay, all these things. Buildings is not a plant. Building is building separately. Furniture fittings, they are not plant. Okay, livestock are not plant. Plant doesn't include animal, human body, or stock in trade. Stock in trade means your inventory items. What you are trading, you are buying and selling, they are not plant. Okay, then plant includes plant, that means engine of a vehicle or spare parts, they are also can be considered as plant. Okay, and building includes roads, bridges, culverts, wells, tube wells, all of them shall be regarded as building. Okay, so this is the meaning of these conditions or these points you have to keep in mind. And one more important condition is that in order to charge depreciation, one has to ensure that assets should be actually used by the assessee for the purpose of business. If it is used for some personal purposes, then that's not a business asset. Consequently, depreciation will not be allowed. Okay, it must be used for business purpose. Secondly, it must be put to use. Okay, put to use means at any time during the previous year. It's not that it should be continuously used throughout the period, not necessary. But it must be put to use for some time during the period. Okay, for example, even let us say, if put to use subsequently learning that concept, various courts have decided that even if an asset is ready to be used, that will be considered as put to use. For example, you have kept a generator in your business. Intention is that if power goes off, you can use it. But fortunately, you didn't use it during the previous year. Luckily, it has happened that power didn't went and you also didn't use it. But generator is ready for use. In that case, it will be also considered that generator is used. Meaning, it is passively used. So when I say asset should be put to use, this includes both active use as well as passive use. Okay, we'll have detailed discussion of this concept later on, maybe in next session. Okay, so as I told you, depreciation need not be, asset need not be used throughout the period. Suppose it is used for 1 month. It's not that we have to charge depreciation on a proportionate basis. No, you have to charge depreciation for the entire period. Only thing is that on the year of acquisition of the asset, if asset is put to use for less than 180 days, then you have to charge 50% of the depreciation. Otherwise, depreciation is not going to be appropriated. Okay, But in one situation, depreciation may be charged on a proportionate basis when an asset is not used exclusively for business purposes. For example, if the asset is used partly for business purposes and partly for personal use, then proportionately you have to charge depreciation. Whatever is the depreciation, you find it out, then a logical proportion of that should be allowed. Okay, did you understand up to this concept? So asset needs to be used. Asset needs to be used for business purpose. If it is used for some other purpose, then you have to find out the proportionate use for business purposes. Okay, and it need not be used throughout the period. Active use and passive use, both shall be considered as use. Okay, and this concept I had already told you several times. One thing is that if asset is used for less than 180 days in the year of its acquisition, where asset is acquired during the previous year and it is put to use for less than 180 days, the depreciation shall be allowed. How much? How much? Can you read it here?
At 50%.
50% of allowable depreciation. That means if original depreciation is 20%, it will be allowed as 10%. Not that 50% depreciation will be allowed. 50% of the allowable depreciation. We need to find out what is the allowable depreciation. 50% of that will be allowed. And that is why businessmen always plan to buy the asset in the first half of the previous year. If they buy in the first half, then it will be used for more than 180 days. So that is the concept. Friends, today we stop our session right now. And from here onwards, we'll be again continuing. I'll be showing you some other example how to calculate depreciation. And with that, I think you'll feel comfortable to compute your taxable income by using depreciation concept. You can think of some tax planning aspects also. Thank you very, very much. Thanks a lot. We'll catch up in your next class.